it. Hi, everybody. Welcome back to EA Sports. I'm James Cebulski. We will crown a champion tonight. Just moments away from puck drop, both teams seem ready to go. This is what you play for. Moments like this, you can feel the energy in this building, and we are underway. Here's a blast, and that's blocked from someone in front. Right up the gut into the offensive end. A little bump and grind, but still hangs on to the puck. Steps inside the line. Passes it in front, and that doesn't go as it's off the stick. Edmonton's moving it along the wing. And that's knocked away by McAvoy. Moves it quickly over to Pastrnak. The Bruins play it along the wing. Denies him! He got all of it! Sends it down low. And they come up with it as the puck skips out. Puck scooped up by Hyman. Now a quick pass to Nugent Hopkins. The Oilers work it through center. The Bruins get a hold of the puck in their own end. Over the line they come. Tries to make a move and can't hang on to the puck.
Lindholm's such a great player, James. He's got great hands and in-tight skill, but just that extra move there, it's a tricky one, and he gets lost in it.
Right through center and into the offensive zone. Edmonton's got it behind the net. Arvidsson's got it in the defensive end. And that's off a stick. The Bruins have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Moves the puck along the half wall. Swatted away with the stick in the defensive zone. Taken along the wall by Dreisaitl. On the attack along the boards. Back at the point, they set it up. That's blocked. Scooped up along the wall by Dreisaitl. Picked off by Poitras. Boston's got it in their own zone. Here's a short pass to Brazil. And a stick in the lane ends that threat. Marchand's got it along the wing. Back to the point it goes. Devastating collision.
In order to dictate the tempo of the game right at the onset of it, you want to make your opponent think and hear you coming, and that's what he does with that first hit.
Quick pass over to Brazil. Oh, great move to sidestep the check. Good positioning there to knock it away with the glove. Move in all alone! Oh, beautiful save on the play!
And you gotta love these one-on-one battles. In particular, the goaltender so aggressive, tracks the puck and makes the save.
Well past the midway mark of this period. We've still got zeros on the board. Edmonton's got it in the offensive zone. Up to the challenge as he gets his pad on it.
Oh, wow! Devastating hit there!
Oh, painful, James. I felt that one in the broadcast booth.
Officials are in position, and both teams are getting ready as they get set for another face-off here. The Oilers win the draw here in their own end. Edmonton's got the puck in the defensive end. Oh, making his presence felt with a hit. Passes it to Kostelec. And that's broken up in the defensive zone by Emberson. Slides the puck across to Ryan. Kostelec taking it from his own end. Jostling for the puck, and he loses control. Takes a shot. Scores! Right on target. Wow.
Yeah, that's unbelievable, isn't it, James? That shot goes top cheese and just knocks the bottle off the top of the net. It's a pass. It almost felt like he was running out of room there, James, but he just outweighed the goaltender. It's all about the deke and the sell there, and then sliding it by the post. Beauty move.
Edmonton's done a nice job staying with their game, and it finally pays off here, Cheryl, with a goal.
Yeah, when you trust the process and you stay to task, this is exactly what happens. You have good habits, you find a way to get it done, and you execute. Now you got to build on it. You got to find a way.
game with consistency.
Grabbed along the board by Echo. Quick feed to Bouchard. And that's blocked in traffic. Good hit to Pope about the puck.
Pasternak, lead smash.
Scores!
Well, that's number two, Palmer. Yeah, he's been all over the puck tonight. He's feeling it. He's confident. You gotta believe he's gonna be looking for the happy. Looks like the game slows down for him. He gets to position and he tracks the puck. You talk about goaltenders tracking it. How about him sitting there in the slot, eyes on it all the way, and now the timing to be able to redirect it into the net. After that last goal, the coach is showing his displeasure with his team. He's just not happy with the effort and the details at this moment.
Edmonton's in control of this one so far, Cheryl, wouldn't you say, with a two-goal lead?
Absolutely, James, and often you don't see this urgency until the end of the game, but they started with it, and as a result, they've got a two-goal lead.
Great reach with the poke check. Feeds the puck to Peake. The Bruins will play it in their own end. Boston's got it along the wall. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck now. Throws one up to McDavid. Broken up in the neutral zone by Kiki. Peake's been tripped up, and we got a penalty coming up here. And the play is whistled dead. Here's the call.
Anytime you lose position on your opponent, this can happen. He gets the sticks out in the feet of his opponent, and guess what? He gets the tripping call.
Well, this gives us our first chance to take a look at the team's power play unit.
First opportunity on the power play in this game. And specialty teams are the difference so many times in a game. Huge for them to set the tone and really get the setup and the looks they're looking for.
Gets it out of his own end. Puts it on net. Gets a glove on it to make the save.
Well, the shooter's in a coveted spot on the ice, right in the middle of it with a good look, and he makes an incredible save by getting square to the puck and turning it aside.
Henrique's ready for the draw as they will continue to try to kill off this penalty. The Oilers win the defensive zone faceoff. Both sides mixed up for that battle for the puck along the wall. And that's poked away in the offensive zone by Lindholm. Moving into the attacking zone. Jostles the puck loose. And that's a solid clearing attempt on the play. Fires it into the offensive zone. Moves it to Kiki. And it's a quick pass to Pasternak. From center, they get into the attacking area. Quick pass to Kiki. Here's a shot, and that's broken up. With the stop. Goaltender covers it up, and we'll get a reset here. Nugent Hopkins is ready for the face-off as they'll continue to kill off this penalty. Back underway as he wins the draw inside the offensive zone. Skinner's gonna hang on to the puck for a whistle. Coyle's ready for the draw as we get set to resume this power play. Edmonton's gonna start with the puck in their own end. More time off the clock as they grab the puck. Picked up along the boards by Bouchard. And he can't hang on after that hit. And now it's grabbed by Lindholm. Hyman's out of the box. He owes a lot of credit to that penalty-killing unit.
Well, when you get the nod to hit the ice on a power play, you want to execute at least 20% of the time. And all these players are heading back to the bench, and they're deflated.
They gain the zone from the left side. A feed out front, and that's stopped. Knocked around, but keeps it going. And he slides it quickly to Draisaitl. Sorry, pass, and that doesn't connect. And that'll put a bow on the first 20 minutes of action here tonight. We've got lots more still to come. Second period is just around the corner.
Hey fans, don't forget to pick up your team calendars. They're available in section 144 at the team kiosk.
Two's up because the second period's about to go down. Puck is dropped and the clock is ticking now here on the second period. Well, we've seen a pretty good sample size already played thus far. Cheryl, your assessment.
Skinner's been fantastic in the game so far, James. I mean, he's the only reason his team is still in it.
Can't find the net!
I don't know how there's no coverage here, James, with that kind of shot coming at you from the point. He gets all of it. It's a thunderclapper, but the only noise that's coming now is from the end boards.
And that's broken up with a
pedal to the metal.
Edmonton's added yet another to extend this lead, and they are just flying tonight here in period number two.
And they've completely worn their opponent down, so they have no energy to get to the puck or try and create. And this is a testament to their whole lineup. They came ready to play.
Moves it quickly over to McDavid. Edmonton's got the puck against the half wall. That's some smart heads-up defensive play by Lindholm. Handles the pass. Can't hang on to the biscuit after that. Battling for it along the boards. The Oilers gain control of the puck against the wall.
Oh, right hit to the opposition bench and getting up close and personal with some people I don't think he really wants to.
Not a chance. I mean, he's over the boards here, and everyone's kind of giving that extra shove, the extra mid-ball, if you will, and then get the heck off our bench. Marchand's the one to lead the comeback here. He's the captain of this team with an offensive zone faceoff. No better way to create some momentum than get one on the board.
Dreisaitl's won the draw in his own end. Now let's see if they can clear it. Tries to get the puck over to Arvidsson. Tried to get 2Q with it and loses possession.
Arvidsson's tried a great move there. We all know what great hands he is in tight, trying to create some space, but it bobbles off his stick and he lost possession.
Coyle's got it in the offensive zone.
Oh, Knysom with the paddle save.
This is a dialed-in goaltender, very aware, knows where the shooter is in that low slot, and makes the save.
Here's a chance in front.
Well, he fought for position to find this puck on his backhand, James. He's running out of real estate, but he was able to put it through and find the netting. Well, it's obvious that the coach is visibly frustrated after that last goal. I mean, they just keep deflating as this game goes on, and they can't figure out a way to get out of it. The coach has to pull some punches, make some adjustments to see if he can get his team back in it.
The Oilers can do no wrong this evening, especially in the offensive zone here, Cheryl.
Well, the score is a testament to the way they've been playing. I mean, they've been dominating in the offensive zone. They've had the puck on their stick. They're driving play, but they've been really urgent, even with the lead here. A great game for them so far. Boston's entire team has been real lackluster from the beginning of this game. They looked ill-prepared at puck drop, and the only saving grace is they have half a game left to try and claw their way back into it.
And now he moves it quickly to Henrik. And that's broken up. Tries to get the puck to Brazil. Oh, look at this. Knocks the puck down with a stick. Broken up with the stick in the defensive end. And the puck leaves the offensive end. They'll be forced to do it over from center. Quick shot! Big time stop! And they'll cover it up, forcing a stoppage in play. Inching closer to the midway mark of the period, the Oilers have a 4-goal lead. Ryan's won the faceoff, and now let's see what they can do.
Oh, what a save on the slapper!
Gets the puck in deep. Slides it over with pace to Emberson.
Just a crushing hit against the wall.
Keeps control of the puck after taking a little knock. Battle along the boards. Forces the turnover in the offensive zone. He says, let's get physical on that play. Here's a short pass to Beecher. slides into Saka. Nice poke check. Edmonton's got a hold of the puck. And he slides it quickly to Draisaitl. Edmonton's got the puck against the boards. Picked up along the wall by Draisaitl. Quick feed to Bouchard. Edmonton's got it near the point. From the point, they take control of it. The Oilers looking against the half wall. Now a quick pass to Draisaitl. And that's knocked away in the defensive end by Zadorov. Scores! The Oilers light them up!
Coaches preaching all the time, take away the eyes of the goaltender. What does that mean? It means you get yourself in front of that net, whether it's a double stack, a double screen, whatever you can do so that the goaltender can't find the puck. And he couldn't as he drops to that butterfly. He tries to make himself as big as possible, but he can't catch up to the puck.
Edmonton's been on a roll all night long, and they continue to show no signs of slowing down here in period number two.
Yeah, they're not taking their foot off the gas pedal here, James. They've been pushing and pressing all game long, and look at the scoreboard. It's the reason why they're ahead.
More than half the frame has been played here. Edmonton's offense is showing no signs of slowing down as they have extended this blowout. Boston's won it. Now they'll go on the attack. Goaltender covers it up. We get a whistle to slow things down. Centers are lined up, and we are ready to resume. The Bruins win that offensive zone faceoff. Oh, one of his teammates was right in the shooting lane there. Delayed penalty coming up here. Whistle blows, stopping the play.
The coach is simply wanting an explanation as to why his team keeps getting penalized, and just a reasonable explanation, that's all it takes. It's composed, though.
The Bruins once again send out their power play unit.
When you're struggling on your power play, you got to get your shots through. Net front presence, take away the eyes of the goaltender. And when there's a rebound, you have to find a way to convert on the second or third opportunity.
Into the offensive end now. Tap dances around the check. Feeds it to Marchand. Feeds it over. And he's got the answer for that one.
Stuffs him again. Not sure if anyone's helping him out there, but he's dialed in and doing it all himself, making consecutive saves.
From their own end as they get a fresh set of legs here for this man advantage. And now it's over to Kiki. And that was read perfectly. What a play by Janmark. Takes a hit but still hangs on to the puck. Oh, he delivered a big time hit there.
And I like it, James. I mean, you're getting blown out here. It's about time someone steps up and does something to turn the tide.
Passes it over. Here's a shot. Oh, what a save in front.
The goaltenders are the last line of defense for a reason. This time, he bails his team out.
Special teams so important. Can they capitalize on this power play here with a faceoff? Henrique's won the faceoff. Trying to get the puck out of his own end. Well, they can't clear, but they still hang on to it. And that's taken away in the offensive end by Poitras. Covers it up, and we'll get a stoppage in play. Here in the late going of the frame, the Oilers all over them tonight. They lead it 5-0. Kulak's back out onto the ice as we are back to even strength here. Scores! And that's his first goal of the postseason ever. And he'll take it.
It's much needed too, James. You get to the playoffs, you want to make sure that your teammates have trust in you and you have trust in yourself because you want to be an impact player. That's a nice start.
The Bruins now need to find a way to get a few more of those.
Yeah, they need them, because if they get that pushback and they can get a couple more, they'll feel like they have an opportunity to win the game, and then the sticks get heavy on the other side. But a lot of work to do to make that happen.
Great reach with the poke check by Kulak. And he takes the dish. Moves it to Nurse. Boston's got possession of the puck. They fight for it along the boards. Boston's got it in the neutral zone. They put the puck into the offensive end. Kulak's lugging the puck. Blows him up on that hit. Quick pass to Skinner. Rocks him on the play.
Power forwards can be so difficult to contain. Why? Because you can hear them coming, James. They have the ability to deliver bone-crushing hits.
There it is. That's a wrap for period number two. Both teams will get a chance to get a little breather here, and we'll come back. Third period action next. Signals both teams into position. Game is not over yet. Let's see if they can try to rally back here in the third, but they've got a long way to go. Cheryl, 40 minutes in the books now played. How do you view this one?
The Oilers have a comfortable lead here in the third period, James. They do not have to change a thing. Don't alter the game plan. Just close it out.
We're still in the early stages of this period. The Oilers have been all over them tonight. 5-1 is where we sit. Forces the turnover, comes up with the puck. Misses! Edmonton's got the puck along the boards. Sends the pass over. And tries to make a diagonal pass to McDavid. And that plays offside. We got a faceoff coming up. The Bruins have looked good tonight, but they still trail here early in this third period despite leading in the shot department. Edmonton's got possession of the puck after that neutral zone faceoff. Moves it quickly over to Nugent Hopkins. And that shot dies in traffic. And now he passes it to Pasternak. Takes a shot. Grabs the puck in the corner. He got all of that one. Oh, comes up with a stop. Centers get set as they're ready to drop the puck again. The Bruins take possession off the faceoff. And he gets in the lane to block that. Puck picked up by Geeky. Battle along the wall. Boston's got a hold of it along the wall. Up along the wing. From the left side into the middle of the neutral zone. Boston's looking to break out. Here's a short pass to Geeky. And he sidesteps the check there. And he maintains possession of the puck here. Arvidsson's moving the puck through his own zone. Oh, and some smooth skating to lose a defender there. Here's a shot. Scores! And with that, I believe that's his first career playoff goal.
Big confidence boost to send him through the next game. Well, this is a great goal. A goal scorer's goal, actually, James. The quick release shot, you're keeping your feet moving to be able to shoot it in stride. You got to know exactly where you are on the ice as well. So some key awareness to be able to get that goal.
The Oilers continue to attack the net here in period number three, adding yet another goal to their score.
Well, it's been all areas of the game that have really been terrific tonight, James. We've also enjoyed the communication that we're seeing on the ice, not just the body language, but also the vocalness. I mean, they're creating all over the ice, and it's been real fun to watch.
Looking to make something happen along the boards. Taken along the wall by Perry. Slides it across. And that's a great heads-up play by Quattro. Drives to the crease. Stopped with a blocker by Skinner. Takes that pass back at the
point. Blocked in traffic.
So much pressure on this shift. They have their opponent running around everywhere, really chasing the game. This is exactly what you want.
Shot. Oh, there's a great stop by Cromisalo.
And the puck stopper hangs on to get a breather here for the team.
The Bruins' enemy is starting to become the clock as they still trail here in the third, despite several scoring chances.
Edmonton's got it, and they're on the attack. And that's deflected off someone in front.
Boston's got the puck. Slides it quickly to Jones.
Edmonton's grabbed a hold of the puck.
Takes the feed. Big blocker stop by Cromisalo. Here's a blast. Oh, and another stop.
Man, James, he shows incredible quickness right there as he makes one and then the second save.
Officials have got both teams ready, and it looks like play is set to resume here.
The Bruins win the draw. Takes the feed in the middle of the ice.
Pastrnak's got to be the player that sparks his team. Everyone knows that he's their star sniper, and he just can't find the back of the net and is extremely frustrated.
And it's a quick pass to McDavid. Great use of the body to knock him off the puck.
Boston's in on the offensive attack now.
Edmonton's made a line change, and it's the second line that comes out, and they've been real effective in this game, James. They've contributed offensively. It was a nice luxury to have as a coach when you just look down your lineup and there's your second line and they've been your top producers.
And off the draw, they win possession.
And he loses control here. Slides the puck over. Nowhere for that shot to go through.
Skates across the blue line.
Look at that hit. Maybe try to wear down the opponents here.
The Oilers move the puck in the defensive zone. And he slides it quickly to Kulak.
Oh, another hit. This guy's all about ruthless aggression tonight.
Well, he certainly is. His feet are always moving, and they've been clean body on body, but certainly sending a message and setting the tempo.
Oh, he got all that. What a save by Skinner.
Janmark's got the puck in his own zone.
Trying to engage a little physicality here.
Denied by the goaltender.
Scooped up along the wall by Marchand.
Gets the puck in deep.
Quick feed to Nurse.
And now he moves it quickly to Ryan.
Puck grabbed by Brown.
It's a contact sport, people. There's proof right there.
Gaining momentum in the offensive end.
Oh, big time save by Skinner.
Great positioning by the goaltender to redirect it to the corner, getting it out of danger.
Dumps it into the O-zone.
Moves it to Kiki.
And he slides it quickly to Putrov.
Edmonton's gained possession along the boards.
And he gives it over to Kulak.
And now he moves it to Perry.
Shot! Oh, tremendous save on the play!
What an incredible save. No idea how he got to that one, James. And the shooter is absolutely stunned. What a stop.
And he sprints to the bench to get the extra attacker out on the ice.
Grabbed along the boards by McAvoy.
Blocked in traffic.
The Bruins played along the boards.
Quick pass to McAvoy. Goaltender gave up nothing as it hits the outside of the post and will play on.
And another call against the home team, and these fans have, I think they've had enough.
They've had enough, and they're booing at the officials. And for the players, this is so frustrating. You try and kind of get the temperature of the way the official's going to call the game, and real tough to read when you get three in a row like that.
Boston's got the puck inside the offensive zone.
Strong in the net tonight, and his save percentage is really high, James, and it's because he's faced a high volume of shots and he's been dialed in and able to make the saves. That gives his team confidence, and they've been consistent as well, and they've done the job on the other side of the puck.
Oh, it stops again!
And the crowd's on their feet, saluting the team after a hard-fought effort this evening. Keeps a hold of it on the play.
show.
Wow. Everyone has to execute their role to the best of their ability to be able to hoist the cup. How many players play an entire career and never get this moment? You need to savor it, embrace it, and they'll never forget it.
Truth has arrived, Lord. Stanley's in the house, Pounder.
Stanley's in the house, and the question is, who's going to raise it first?
And here comes Cap, the engine, the lifeblood, the heart and soul of this squad, and he's finally a Stanley Cup winner.
Yeah, for the first time, to be able to hoist that cup is an incredible feeling. I can just imagine the emotion that's circulating through his veins. But he's done everything for this team, both on and off the ice. This is a deserved and earned moment.
Smiles here as he takes the cup for a skate, Cheryl.
Well, yeah, and there's a reason why everyone sticks around for this moment, because they want to see everyone touch the cup. Why? Because no matter what your role was, you are a part of a team that will hold the bond together forever.
Well, his playmaking ability was a huge reason why they won the Stanley Cup, and now he gets his hands on it, Cheryl.
Yeah, and those hands delivered some gifts, didn't they? I mean, he was so elusive and deceptive, and you have to be to open up some space in a tight game in the playoffs. Now they're all rewarded with the Stanley Cup.
You know, for some routines, Cheryl, you say it's old hat. I don't think winning the Stanley Cup multiple times ever gets tiresome.
Oh, it can't be, James. And it's no fluke, right? You know that he plays in the regular season, how difficult it is to make the playoffs. And then to be able to go round after round, I'm telling you, he's seasoned, and that lends right through the dressing room.
The celebration continues, and they're all converging at center ice for the team pick.
Yeah, hard to believe that so many of them are banged up. Hey, James, at the arduous process of getting to the Stanley Cup final, but that's why they're all in one heap, showing the pure elation of the moment.